When you open a tap, you expect water to flow, at least in most of the world's cities. We need clean water to wash ourselves and our clothes, to cook with, to flush waste, and of course to sustain us. But across the world, from Bangalore in India to Los Angeles in the US, cities are facing a severe water crisis. Clean fresh water, once a seemingly plentiful renewable resource, is increasingly scarce. So, is our planet running out of fresh water? When it comes to sheer quantity, the Earth has plenty of water, about 326 million cubic miles or 1.3 billion cubic kilometers of it. But although 71% of the Earth's surface is covered by water, most of this water, or more than 97%, is in saline oceans, making it largely unusable. Of the remaining 3% that's fresh water, nearly two-thirds is locked up in glaciers and ice caps. That leaves a little more than 1% stored underground or on the surface in rivers or lakes for our use. Even so, it's not that we lack fresh water. The problem is that not all of it is accessible or clean. And the water that is accessible is not always where people live. The biggest problem of all is that many freshwater sources that humanity relies on are being depleted faster than they're being replenished. Take agriculture, the largest guzzler of freshwater. It accounts for more than 70% of water usage globally, with most going to irrigation. Industry comes second at 20%. So nearly every food item or manufactured product we consume has a hidden water cost. A 250-gram cotton t-shirt requires about 2,500 liters of water to grow that cotton and manufacture the garment. A cup of coffee, about 130 liters. Half a kilogram of corn, around 400 liters. The last 10% of fresh water goes into domestic use, the water we use when we open our taps. Clearly, we already use a lot, but consumption of water has soared. Studies show that global water demand has risen 600% in the last 100 years. And as human population and consumption increase further, water demand across homes, agriculture, and industry is set to skyrocket. Some forecasts suggest that by 2050, food demand will increase by 60%, with water usage rising along with it. In industry, water demand could rise by 800% in Africa and 250% in Asia. Domestic usage is projected to rise by up to 300% in some regions of Africa and Asia by 2050. Freshwater sources are already failing under this immense pressure. Numerous wetlands, lakes, and rivers have greatly diminished or are dying as cities build over them, pollutants are dumped into them, or dams block their flow. A third of the world's biggest groundwater aquifers are already severely overdrawn. And with climate change projected to bring more drought worldwide, some cities like Cape Town in South Africa and Sao Paulo in Brazil could wake up one day to dry taps. A recent analysis by the World Resources Institute found that 17 countries, home to a quarter of the Earth's population, are under extreme water stress. Their agriculture, industry, and municipalities remove 80% of available surface and groundwater in an average year, with climate change set to make shifts in rainfall patterns and drought far worse. In fact, by 2025, an estimated 1.8 billion people will live in areas plagued by water scarcity. Because of this, scientists say that freshwater is a planetary boundary. They think that humanity's soaring freshwater usage could destabilize living ecosystems, the water cycle, and global climate, reaching a tipping point beyond which the Earth could become inhospitable for human survival. Given our current pace and patterns of consumption, we could cross this boundary this century, though exactly when is hard to predict. But we don't have to, as examples from around the world have shown. For instance, from 1997 to 2009, Melbourne survived the worst drought in Australia's recorded history by rapidly adopting policies that included wastewater recycling and construction of rainwater storage systems. By 2010, residents of the city had cut their water use to half of pre-drought levels. In Cape Town, residents helped pull the city from the edge of disaster in 2018 when they cut their water use to 50 liters a day. This is the minimum amount necessary to meet a person's basic needs according to the World Health Organization. The city is now adopting a new view of water management, that of water resilience, to face a future where water scarcity is the norm. In Israel, the Shavdan wastewater treatment facility near Tel Aviv recycles about 140 million cubic meters of sewage water annually and supplies it for the irrigation of 20,000 hectares of farmland. So, planning matters. Our societies can become much more water efficient, but it will take public and political will and resolve. It will require us to change how we grow food, make products, and consume fresh water. Think about that the next time you open a tap.